In this problem, we're looking at a harmonic oscillator with an inelastic collision involved. So we're taking a sticky blob with a given mass of 200 grams or 0.2 kilograms, and we shoot that at a mass that's attached to a spring, and that has a mass of 400 grams or 0.4 kilograms. And that blob sticks to the block in a perfectly inelastic collision. At the end of that collision, there's going to be some initial speed V for the harmonic oscillator part of the problem. Then we'll use that speed in order to find the maximum compression of the spring. And then finally, we'll find the time for this combined mass to return back to the equilibrium position. That, of course, is related to the period of oscillation for this harmonic oscillator. So we start by looking at momentum conservation during the collision, and that's going to give us the velocity of the combined masses right at the beginning of the oscillation part. So we say P initial is equal to P final for the collision. My initial momentum is all in that sticky blob, and that's just mass times velocity, or 0.2 times 5.5. My final momentum is in the motion of the combined masses, and the spring has not compressed yet, so we don't have to worry about the external force on these masses. And when they're combined, that's 600 grams or 0.6 kilograms multiplied by that speed after impact, V. So we run the numbers on this and we find that V is 1.833 meters per second, just keeping a little extra precision for the moment. And then to get to the maximum compression of the spring, well, that's the moment where all the energy is in the compression of the spring and the mass is motionless. So it's an energy conservation problem, where in the initial state, I'm at the equilibrium position with no spring potential energy and it's all kinetic. So I'm gonna have a 1/2 times the combined masses, I'll just call that little m, times the speed at that moment squared. All the energy is kinetic. And then again, when I get to the point of max compression, all the energy is going to be spring potential energy. So I'll call it 1/2 kx max squared. And it's the x max that we're after. So we can multiply by 2 on both sides. Solve for the maximum compression, so we divide by k and square root the result. Plug in the numbers, we had a mass of 0.6 kilograms moving at a speed of 1.833 meters per second. And we were told in the problem the spring constant is 9.5 newtons per meter. And this gives me 0.461 meters, or it might be a little nicer to write that as 46.1 centimeters maximum compression. So after reaching maximum compression, this combined mass is going to turn around and spring back through the equilibrium position. We want to find the total time to get from equilibrium back to equilibrium again. And the key to this is that the time we're looking at is exactly 1/2 of an oscillation. So I'm looking at 1/2 the period of oscillation for this simple harmonic oscillator. Well, the period of a simple harmonic oscillator is given by 2 pi root m over k, and the 2's cancel there, and I get pi times the square root of m over k. Again, the oscillating mass is the entire 600 grams or 0.6 kilograms, and k was 9.5 newtons per meter. Into 3 sig figs, I get 0.790 seconds, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.